Hello, beautiful and magnificent beings. Welcome to Energy and Light. How's everybody doing? Have you pulled through the week of ascension symptoms? And just to warn you off the bat, I am going to be doing a little bit of talking first before the session. I've had some people complain about that recently. So just letting you know ahead of time if you want to skip ahead. But this has been a crazy week. Definitely one of the most extreme that I've experienced, especially in a while. Normally ascension symptoms, I just feel exhausted, you know, extremely low energy. I can't focus or do anything. But this week was really interesting. Each day was actually something different. And when I posted my last three regular Reiki videos, I was already starting to feel it, but I didn't realize what was going on. I just thought maybe I was, you know, I needed some rest or to change my diet up or something. And I was not planning on taking an entire week off. I thought maybe just one or two days, but as that went by, it was more of a struggle. And every day it was like, it just kept getting worse and worse. And today is the best I've felt. I'm still not 100% yet, but I'm getting there, and I just wanted to share some of the things that I went through. I always find this helpful because you guys always share what you went through as well, and not everyone goes through this. Sometimes people do, but they don't realize what it is. But for those of you that are very familiar with me talking about this when I go through it in the past, and some of you go through it, please let us know what you experienced. Of course, the exhaustion, the severe drain of not being able to do anything, and I mean nothing. I couldn't even shower the entire week. It was so bad. Like, I was just lying on the bed or on the couch and listening to audiobooks or watching a movie or something. It's all I could do. So one of the first things I went through was hypersensitivity. I have never experienced anything like this. Sometimes if a car would go past the house or a really loud bike, because I'm in the desert, there's a lot of three-wheelers and mountain bikes and things going on. And I remember literally having to cover my ears, like cringing, like I could just feel the pain, the sound in my entire body. It was so bizarre. And I'm always careful what I watch, but sometimes I can drift towards other types of movies or series or something that I wouldn't normally watch. And this was another thing, like immediately within seconds of watching something, I would just start to feel horrible, like the energy coming off of it was just terrible. So I resorted to mostly comedy, something uplifting or animation. I love animation. It always helps me reconnect to high vibrational energy or just feeling good. So the hypersensitivity, let me see. Oh, euphoric. There was one day that I was absolutely euphoric. Even though I was exhausted, I did have a little bit more energy, but I felt like I was on something. Like literally, if I had a roommate, I would swear that they had drugged me or something, because I felt so euphoric, incredible, just really uplifted. And I almost felt like some of these experiences are really difficult to explain because it's more of a feeling. But during that period of being euphoric, I kind of felt detached. I mean, I was in my body, I could feel it, I was moving, but there was just like a detachment. There was absolutely, it was almost like no feeling. There was absolutely no pain, or, you know, sometimes we have issues. There was nothing like that, and it lasted from the time I woke up until the time I went to sleep. Another thing was, another day I had this anxiety and fear, like I was literally freaking out, like there was nothing specific wrong, and I was like, what is going on? I'm just assuming I was feeling a lot of the fear. I know there was a lot of crazy misguided people posting information about the eclipse, and so I think there was a lot of fear-based trauma and energy going on out there, and I was just picking up on it again, hypersensitive, because I couldn't focus. I was nervous, a wreck, shaking, anxiety, and just fearful. And finally, by the end of the day, it started to calm down and go away. Let me see what else. Purging, definitely purging, which is hilarious because one of my last videos was all about Kali and purging. Well, mine just kept going the entire week. I was experiencing it mentally and also physically. And some ways I'm not even sure what was being purged because I've talked about this before, but for those people that are new to my channel, when I meditate in the mornings, I experience, which I think is Kundalini Kriyas. So my body kind of shakes and moves, my arms or my hands move. Sometimes I do rhythmic tapping or weird things on my body. Sometimes I'll start speaking spontaneous light language or humming or just something. And I noted there was a lot of work going on in my neck and in my throat and also the heart and my crown chakra. Like my hands were doing some kind of work. I was going into breath of fire, but also something I hadn't experienced. There was a lot of deep, like just breathing up from the root and blowing out for long periods of time all of this air. I could just feel I was releasing something. My voice is still a little raspy. You can probably tell my voice has been off. So a lot of purging physically, emotionally. There was a lot of memories being released, like stuff I'd completely forgotten, just like little snippets, little pictures of things and people that had happened, and it would just come up and be gone. I was definitely sleeping longer. Like there was some days I was sleeping 10 to 11 hours. I would wake up and I was like, oh my God, half the day's gone. Let me see what else I mentioned about the memories coming up. That was most of it. And then it started to calm down, like just the day before yesterday, I could feel myself starting to calm down again. Meditation was the best thing for me. Also, again, the animation. I mean, I know it's different for everybody, but just something with really powerful uplifting, especially connecting to my inner child, really helps me. So this was definitely a crazy one. I don't know if it was the Schumann resonance was off again or if it was because of the eclipse. Who knows? I didn't really investigate. Normally when I feel this way, I kind of check with people and see what they know or what's going on, but I didn't bother doing it this time. I just kind of tried to ride it out. It was a different experience every day, which was interesting. So let's go ahead and get into the session. So I'm going to infuse my hands with some sandalwood. I just wanted to bring in as much earthiness and grounding as possible. And imagine an energy shower. We're doing something a little bit different today. Imagine you're outside and just imagine the energy of the sun, of the earth. If you're a pluviophile, wink, wink, maybe you're imagining the rain. And just feeling a tingly sensation, also working with some selenite. Just getting a nice flow, getting everything moving. And just feeling that beautiful energy shower. All of the elements coming in, supporting us, our guides, helping us to settle down, to come back into our normal state of being, our normal energy. Some of you may continue to purge. You might continue to experience these ascension symptoms. And some of you might, like myself, you might already be starting to feel better. Maybe close your eyes, feeling tingly energy coming down. Feel it entering through the crown of the head. Literally a shower. Just trying to settle, calm, stabilize everything for you. Just allowing yourself to receive everything that you desire and require. Known and unknown. I find all of the, when this happens, it's usually about an hour. It's usually about a week for me anyway, but I think this is definitely the most intense and definitely the most interesting. I've never had anything like this, as I said, from day to day, that it was completely different. So I found that to be a nice distraction. Washing down over the crown, over the body, the front, the back, the sides, feeling all of that beautiful, healing, luxurious energy raining down. Maybe imagine you're standing in a field of flowers, which I was kind of absolutely going on here. Imagine being in that beautiful meadow, all of those flowers, that sweet scent, hearing the sounds of bees' wings buzzing. Tethering energy cords down from your feet into Mother Earth. Maybe you're barefoot. Settling, calming. Residual turbulence. Hudent tui estish katatai. Unut tui ish nina ata eheniata ustashan katatui kua. Tiena hana ua katayeshku. Hana ti I shniaka ukuthu ui ia haana ata estoshkuka. Readjusting, recalibrating. The energies, it feels a little different today. It's definitely more subtle, very soft and calming, very soothing. Certainly nothing too intense. I don't think some of us can take much more. Ushnu tutui ahanae kukatae ustashanahani ekikiaka ua. Feeling yourself wrapped in a warm, energetic blanket, comforting, calming the mind, settling the emotional states. Take a gentle breath in and slowly out. Whew. Hope this help you to feel better and give you what you need. You may need more than one session, especially when we experience things like these. Thank you so much for joining me today, everyone. Sorry if this video is a little shorter. I'm still recovering, but I had enough energy to pull myself together. I wanted to at least get something out there for you to help you during this time. So thank you so much for joining me. I truly and deeply appreciate you so much. And until my next video, there's much love for you here. Highest blessings and infinite gratitude. Sat Nam.